Hey everyone, it's Josh here with HostGator. Today I want to show you how to check what version of PHP you're using on your site and how to change it through cPanel's MultiPHP Manager. Let's get started. Before we do anything, the first thing I want to show you how to do is create a phpinfo.php page. Now, I'm going to be working on my primary domain today, which is b-redpit.com, and that's going to be stored inside of my public underscore HTML. So we'll scroll down until we find the file manager. We'll click on that icon. And this is going to take me to my cPanel's home directory. So if I'm working inside of public underscore HTML, I need to scroll down and find that folder. And we'll double click here. Now this is where all the content from my website is stored, and I need to create a brand new file. So what I'm going to do is click the top left-hand corner where it says a plus sign next to file. We'll click that, and now we just need to give this new file a name. Now the standard naming convention for a PHP info page is phpinfo.php. You can really name this file anything that you want as long as it has the .php extension at the end. Once I've got it typed in, we'll click the create new file button here. And now it has officially appeared inside of my file manager in the correct directory. And it's essentially an empty file at this point, so now we need to put some content in it so I can actually view the version of PHP that I'm using. We've got a really helpful knowledge base article here, and I'll link this inside the video. What we're going to do is take the content inside of the show all PHP information box, copy that to my clipboard, and then head back over to the file manager. Now we need to edit this file to put some of that data inside of it. So I'll right click on the PHP info page, and I'll click the edit button. That's always going to give you an option to back up the original file. Since there's no content in here, we're not going to need to do that, and I'll just go ahead and click edit. So we are inside of the blank file now. I'm going to paste that information from the PHP info knowledge base article, and then I'm going to click save changes. We've got a nice success bar down here showing me that it's updated, and we can essentially close out of this now. Now that I've got my PHP info page actually created, what I need to do is go and view it in a real browser. So I'll head over to my site, and all we'll need to do is put forward slash and then the name of the file, and then hit enter. And voila, I have a PHP info page. Now I can see that I'm using version 7.1.33, and all of the modules and everything that's loaded inside of that PHP version are listed down here. But today we're really just going to focus on the actual PHP version. So let's say I want to update this to something newer, like 7.2 or perhaps the newer 7.3. I'm going to head back to my cPanel now. And what I want to do is go to the quick functions bar and I'll type in multi. It's going to bring me to MultiPHP Manager. As you can see, this is also in the software section, so if you wanted to scroll down and find it, you can. I like that quick search function. So we'll click on the MultiPHP Manager here. And this page is going to allow me to modify the version of PHP for any domain that I have on my server. I'll scroll down just a little bit here, and I can see all the domains that I have. So since I'm working on my b-redpit, I'm going to select the checkbox next to that domain. And then up here, you'll see that apply button has illuminated. And now we can go ahead and choose the exact version of PHP that I want to use. Now I'm currently using 7.1. I want to go all the way up to 7.3. Choose that from the dropdown and we'll click apply. Got a nice successful message there at the top. And let's head back to our PHP info page and refresh this to see if the change has taken effect. And there we have it. I am now on version 7.3. So really that easy to change the version of PHP that you're using. So if you're on WordPress or a different CMS that needs a more updated version, it's really easy to get that done. Now, if you're using one of the older versions of PHP selector, there may be an option, one of the older add handlers that's inside of your .htaccess file. So I'll show you how to track that down just in case you're receiving any error messages on your site. Let's head back to our cPanel's file manager, and I'll take a look at this .htaccess file. I'm going to right-click that just to view. And down here at the bottom, you'll see the new PHP handler. And if you have an earlier version of PHP or an earlier add handler, it will usually be above this. And if you are noticing any issues on your site, you can use the comments to comment out that in the actual .htaccess file, or you could just simply remove it by editing that file. But as you can see now, we are officially on version 7.3, so I've completely updated my PHP version, and it's really just that simple. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you'll have a great day, and if you have any comments or suggestions, please leave them below, and subscribe if you want to see more helpful videos. Thanks, y'all.